A very good morning, students. In the previous session, we have seen the factors affecting on rate of corrosion and corrosion control techniques. We have seen one of the corrosion control technique. And in factors affecting on rate of corrosion, there are two factors affecting on the rate of corrosion. One is the nature of metal, and another one is the nature of environment. So whatever the factors affecting through nature of metal and through the nature of environment, we have seen in the previous session. And also we have seen one of the corrosion control technique through cathodic protection. But before that, what is mean by the cathodic protection? Cathodic protection is nothing but converting the base metal. What is mean by the base metal? Base metal is nothing but the metal which we want to protect. The metal which is going to be protected is called the base metal or the parent metal. We are converting the parent metal forcibly to the cathode, or coating or connecting that base metal to the anode or cathode. That is called the cathodic protection. In cathodic protection, we are having two methods. One is sacrificial anodic method and another one is the impressed current cathodic protection. In the yesterday's class, we have seen sacrificial anodic protection. What is mean by the sacrificial anodic protection? In sacrificial anodic protection, the parent metal. You know what is mean by the parent metal now? Parent metal is connected to the highly active metal through the wires. What is mean by the highly active metal? Highly active metal is nothing but the metal with lower reduction potential, which is in the top position in electrochemical series. So when the parent metal is connected to highly active metal, like this diagram, this is the parent metal or the base metal, and the parent metal is connected to highly active metal with the help of wires. So it is highly active metal. So it is acting as the anode because it is highly active metal. When it is acting as the anode, it will be acting as the cathode. So the dust particles will react with only anode, not with the cathode. That means anode is undergo oxidation and cathode will be protected. So that is about the sacrificial anodic protection. Now let us see the next method, that is the impressed current cathodic protection. In this method, an impressed current is applied in opposite direction to nullify the corrosion current. Nullifying is nothing but stopping or removing. What we are doing in this, we are applying the current. This current is called the impressed current. How we are applying the impressed current? We are applying the impressed current in the opposite direction of the corrosion current. What is mean by the corrosion current here? Corrosion current is nothing but the current which is passing from the anode to cathode. So generally we know that current will be passing from anode to cathode. But here we know that anodic part is undergo oxidation and anodic metal is undergo corrosion, and cathodic metal is going to be protected from the corrosion. So here the current will be passing from corrosive metal to the protective metal. That current is called the corrosion current. When we are applying more than the corrosion current in the opposite direction is nothing but from cathode to anode. When we are applying that, the current will be stopping, that means nullifying. That is called the impressed current. So why we are applying in the opposite direction? To nullify the corrosion current, to stop the corrosion current. So, and convert the corroding metal from anode to cathode. So when we are converting that, when we are doing the reaction opposite, anode will be converts to cathode and cathode will be converts to anode here. So the impressed current is slightly higher than the corrosion current. For example, if corrosion current is 1 volt, we are applying 1.1 voltage in the opposite direction to nullify the corrosion current. So thus the anodic corroding metal becomes cathodic, protected from the corrosion. So whatever the anode metal is there, that is undergo corrosion. What is our aim? We are converting that anode as the cathode by passing more than the corrosion current in the opposite direction. So the impressed current is taken from your battery or rectified on AC line. So we are taking that impressed current through the battery. The impressed current protected method is used for water tanks, water and oil pipelines, transmission line towers, etc. So for protecting all these buried pipelines, buried water tanks and oil pipelines, transmission line towers, to protect all these, we are using the impressed current cathodic protection, even in the railway tracks also. See here, this is the diagram for the impressed current cathodic protection. See here, we want to protect this underground pipeline. This underground pipeline is made of iron. And we are taking another metal, and that is anode here. And that anode is placing in the backfill, that is the gypsum. And this is one of the inert metal here. This is acting as inert metal. Inert metal is nothing but the metal which is going to be protected. So initially it is anode and it is cathode. But what we are doing, we are converting this anode as the cathode and this cathode as the anode. Maybe you will get one doubt that if we are protecting this metal, this anode will be converts to cathode and this cathode will be converts to anode. What is happening now? Now this metal will be undergo corrosion. Yes, but our aim is that both metals should be protected. Main aim is we have to protect this metal, but also we want to protect this metal also. So to protect this metal also, what we are doing, we are taking one of the inert metal. What is mean by the inert metal? The metal which is not reacting with the environment. So like that, we are doing the impressed current cathodic protection. And the next topic, metallic coating. What is mean by the metallic coating? Metallic coating is nothing but coating of one metal on the another metal. Why we are coating one metal on the another metal? To protect the parent metal. To protect the surface of the parent metal, we are doing the metallic coating. That is nothing but coating of one metal on the another metal. The surface of the base metal is coated with the another metal. Metallic coatings are broadly classified into two types. One is the anodic coating and another one is the cathodic coating. So there are two types of coating, anodic coating and the cathodic coating. In the name itself, we have the meaning. Anodic coating means coating metal will be anode. In cathodic coating, coating metal will be cathode. Let us see what is anodic coating and the cathodic coating. The metal used for the surface coating is more anodic than the base metal, which is to be protected. But before that, before going to understand this point, what is meant by the anodic coating? Coating of the base metal with the anode. What is meant by the anode here? Highly active metal. That means compared to the base metal, the metal which we are coating, that is highly active metal. Only highly active metal is the anode. But where the highly active metal is located in electrochemical series? In electrochemical series, highly active metal is placed at the top position in electrochemical series. Yes. So now let us see this point. The metal used for the surface coating is more anodic than the base metal, which is to be protected. Yes. So whatever the base metal we are using, compared to that, the coating metal must be more anodic. Then only it will be acting as anode and our base metal is acting as a cathode. For example, coating of aluminium, cadmium and zinc on steel surface are anodic because their electrode potentials are lower than that of the base metal of iron. So you know that if lower reduction potentials are there, then only these are acting as the anode. Here, aluminium, cadmium and zinc, these are having the lower reduction potential compared to the iron in the steel. That means iron is having the higher reduction potential than these. If the reduction potential is less, those will be acting as the anode. And iron is having more reduction potential, so obviously it will be acting as the cathode here. Therefore, anodic coatings protect the underlying base metal sacrificially. That means the steel will be protected by coating with aluminium, cadmium, and zinc. These are anode, and our steel is acting as the cathode. Is there any corrosion at cathode? There is no corrosion at the cathode. That means steel will be protected by coating with the anode. But the formation of pores and cracks over the metallic coating exposes the base metal and forms a galvanic cell between the base metal and the coating metal. If the coating metal is nothing but whatever the metal is coated on the base metal. Yes, if the coating metal is having any pores and the cracks, what is happening there? If the coating metal is having any pores or the cracks, the dust particles will be entering through the pores on the base metal. But what is the base metal here? Base metal is a cathode. And our coating metal is the anode. Even the dust particles are going inside and reacting with the base metal, there is no corrosion because the base metal is acting as the cathode. But when the pores and cracks are forming, then the galvanic cell is forming. Why the galvanic cell is forming? Because anode and cathode, these are directly contacting with each other in the presence of electrolyte. So the coating metal dissolves anodically and the base metal is protected because the base metal is acting as the cathode here. That is the advantage in anodic coating. But let us see what is the disadvantage in the cathodic coating. What is mean by the cathodic coating? Cathodic coating means coating of base metal with cathode. If the base metal is coating with the cathode, that is called the cathodic coating. But what is mean by the cathode? Whether it is having lower reduction potential or higher reduction potential? Higher reduction potential. That means compared to our base metal, the coating metal must be having more reduction potential. Then only it will be acting as a cathode. Yes. So compared to our base metal, our coating metal must be more cathodic. That is cathodic coating. Cathodic coatings are obtaining by coating a more noble metal. That means more cathodic metal than the base metal. They protect the base metal as they have higher corrosion resistance than the base metal due to cathodic nature. Because compared to our base metal, the top metals are less active with environment. That means these are not reacting with the environment. When these are not reacting with the environment, the entire surface of the base metal and coating metal will be protected here. But what is the disadvantage here? Let us see that. Cathodic coating protects the base metal only when the coating is uniform and free from the pores. Isn't it? Because if the cathodic coating is having any pores, what is happening over there? The base metal is anode there. The base metal is anode and coating metal is cathode. If cathode coating is having any pores or cracks, the dust particles will be entering on the surface of the base metal. Base metal is anode. So the entire surface of the base metal is undergo corrosion. That is the drawback in the cathodic coating. So it must be free when it is highly preferable when the cathodic coating is free from the pores and the cracks. The formation of pores over the cathodic coating exposes the base metal to environment and a galvanic cell is set up. This causes more damage to the base metal. So now let us see the last topic. Not last topic. After this, we are having one more topic also. So let us see the another topic which comes under metallic coating. Methods of applications of metallic coating. We have only one topic in metallic coating. That is the hot dipping process. Hot dipping process is applicable to the metals having higher melting point than the coating metal. Hot dipping process is applicable to the metals having higher melting point than the coating metal. It is carried out by immersing a well-cleaned base metal in a bath of containing molten coating metal and a flux layer. Just I will explain you. hot dipping process is nothing but coating of low melting metal on the high melting metal. Again, I'm repeating, coating of low melting metal on the high melting metal. One of the metal is having high melting point and another metal is having the low melting point. Whatever the coating metal is there, that is having the low melting point. Low melting point is nothing but it is melting easily. But the base metal is having the high melting point. That means it is not melting easily. What we are doing now, we are dipping the base metal in the low melting point metal. Because the low melting point metal is easily melting and converted to the paste form. When we are dipping the base metal in the low melting point metal, our base metal is completely coated with our low melting point metal because it is converted to the paste when we are heating this. So like that, we are coating the base metal with low melting point metal in the hot dipping process. So that's what we are saying here. It is carried out by immersing, that means dipping a well-cleaned base metal. That means initially we have to clean the base metal. After cleaning only we are doing this process. Because if the base metal is having any dust particles or any moisture or any grease, what is happening over there? The base metal will be reacting with the dust particles and the base metal will be undergo corrosion. So initially we have to clean the base metal. After that, immersing a well-cleaned base metal in a bath containing molten coating metal. Molten is nothing but paste. That we are clean base metal is dipping in the bath of the molten coating metal and a flux layer. This I will explain you later why we are using the flux layer here. So when we are dipping this, the entire base metal is coated with the coating metal. The flux. What is the use of flux here? The flux is cleaning the surface of the base metal and prevents the oxidation of molten coating metal. What is the use of flux here? Flux is cleaning the base metal and also it is preventing the oxidation of coating metal. After coating, it should not be further oxidated with the environment. To prevent that, we are using the flux. Example, coating of zinc, lead, aluminium on iron and steel surfaces. This is the example of hot dipping process. Here, these are coating on the iron and the steel surfaces. But the most widely used hot dipping process are galvanizing and the tinning. We have only two techniques in the hot dipping process. One is galvanizing and another one is the tinning process. In both this process, what we are doing here, we are dipping the clean base metal in the low melting point metal. Yes. So in our syllabus, we are having only galvanizing. We don't have the tinning. So I'm not going to explain you tinning process. But in both the process, low melting point metal is coating on the high melting point metal. But in the galvanizing process, zinc is coating on the iron. That means zinc is a coating metal and iron is the base metal. But in tinning process, tin is coating on the iron. Zinc is coating on the iron, that is galvanizing. Tin is coating on the iron, that is the tinning process. Let us see the galvanizing process. But before that, what we have to do, we have to clean the base metal. Why we have to clean the base metal? Because the base metal will be reacting with the dust particles and undergo corrosion. To prevent that, we have to clean the base metal initially. What is galvanizing? Galvanizing is a process in which the iron article is protected from corrosion by coating it with a thin layer of zinc. Yes, to prevent the iron sheet is coating with the zinc layer, a thin layer of the zinc, that is called the galvanizing process. So simply coating of the zinc on the iron sheet is called the galvanizing process. It is an anodic protection because our iron, that is the base metal, is the cathode, and our zinc, that which is coating one, is the anode here. So it is comes under anodic protection or the anodic coating, and it is the anodic protection offered by the zinc, because zinc is acting as the anode here. And in this process, at first iron or steel is cleaned by pickling with dilute sulfuric acid solution at a temperature range of 60 to 90 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes. So what we are doing initially we have to clean. But how we are cleaning? Initially we are cleaning the iron or steel with dilute sulfuric acid. That is called the acid pickling process. Acid pickling is nothing but the cleaning with acid. That is called acid pickling process. At temperature range of 60 to 90 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes. So what we are doing initially, we are keeping the iron sheet in a bath of acid. What is the acid here? Dilute sulfuric acid for 15 to 20 minutes. Then what is happening? All the dust particles or grease will be removing by washing with the acid. So therefore, it removes scale, rust, and other impurities present, and then washed well in water bath and dried. After washing with the acid, immediately what we are doing? We are washing with the water, and afterwards we are drying this. If we are not drying, again it will be reacting with the water and again undergo corrosion and the rust. Yes? So afterwards we are drying that. So initially what we are doing? Initially, the iron sheet is cleaning in the dilute sulfuric acid at 60 to 90 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes. And afterwards, it is dipping in the water bath and drying. Then after dipping in the bath containing molten zinc, which is at 425 degrees centigrade to 450 degrees centigrade. So after drying, what we are doing? Immediately, we are keeping the iron sheet in the zinc paste, because zinc paste is a coating metal here. So immediately we are placing in the zinc paste at 425 degrees centigrade to 450 degrees centigrade. To prevent it from oxide formation, the surface bath is covered with the ammonium chloride flux. What is the use of flux? Flux is preventing the further oxidation of the coating metal. So to prevent that, after taken out, it should not be oxygenated. So the container will be covered with a flux. When the iron sheet is taken out, it coated with a thin layer of the zinc. After dipping in the zinc, when we are removing that, the entire iron sheet is coated with the zinc. To remove excess amount of zinc, because it is in the form of paste. When it is in the form of paste, maybe it will be leak. Yes, maybe the excess amount of zinc is absorbed by the iron. To remove that excess amount of zinc, what we are doing, immediately it is passed through a pair of hot rollers. In between the pair of hot rollers, the sheet is passing. When the sheet is passing, the excess amount of zinc will be fall down. And then it will be annealed at a temperature of 450 degrees centigrade, followed by cooling. Here, annealing process is nothing but the slowly cooling. After placing in the pair of hot rollers, when we are cooling immediately, what is happening? The entire coating metal will be peel off. To avoid that, we are doing annealing process. Annealing process is nothing but slowly cooling. And galvanizing is widely used for protecting iron exposed to the atmosphere, especially roofs, wire fences, pipes, and screw bolts. In all these cases, we are using the galvanizing. Galvanized metallic sheets are not used for keeping eatables because of the solubility of zinc. Because you can see in the what, especially in the courier covers, not in courier covers, especially in the food parcel covers. Yes, also the zinc can be used, but we should not use because the zinc will be easily melting, because that is a low melting point metal. It should not be eatable because it is poisonous to the human being. So it should not be used in the eatables. Especially you can use in the construction industry and other industry. except eatables. Now let us see the diagram for galvanizing process. What we have done initially, let us assume this circle is the iron sheet. What we are doing initially, iron sheet is placing in the dilute sulfuric acid at 60 to 90 degrees centigrade. What we call this as the acid pickling process. What we are doing initially, iron sheet is placing in the dilute sulfuric acid to remove the scale, rust and other impurities. After removing the impurities, immediately iron sheet is placing in the washing bath, that is a water bath, to remove the remaining impurities. Immediately it is placing in the drying chamber. When we place in the drying chamber, all the moisture will be evaporating. So we will get the dried iron sheet. This dried iron sheet immediately placing in the molten zinc, which is the coating metal. When we place the iron sheet, the entire zinc will be coating on the iron sheet. And this is the ammonium chloride flux. What is the use of ammonium chloride flux? The zinc coating metal should not oxidize with the environment. Further oxidation. To prevent further oxidation, we are using the ammonium chloride flux. But maybe the iron sheet is having excess zinc. To avoid that, immediately placing a pair of hot rollers. So excess amount of zinc will be falling down. And afterwards, the iron sheet is placing in the annealing chamber. Annealing chamber is nothing but slowly cooling. Finally, we will get the galvanized sheet. Yes, this is hot dipping galvanizing process. So in the external examination, they will ask, explain galvanizing process by hot dipping or explain hot dipping process by galvanizing method with need diagram. Yes, it is very, very important question for 6 marks in the external examination. Only one topic left that I will explain you in the next class. Yes, thank you so much.